Hi Libra, this is your forecast for the month of July 2018. This is a general reading for Libra Sun, Libra Rising, or Libra Moon. For a more rounded overview, please watch your rising and moon sign as well. Now, the second week, you have the Eight of Pentacles. So perhaps you are either working with that queen, or she's paying you, or you're paying her. Maybe she's mentoring you, giving you some advice in some way. This is a week where you're focused on your skills and improving yourself in some way, whether that's to move up the corporate ladder, to gain some kind of expertise in something that you do. So it's about being a good worker, and perhaps you're working to get some type of notice. Maybe you're a craftsperson, or you deal with computers, or you have some kind of special talent to offer. Maybe you invent things, or you do things with your hands. For some of you, this is involving teaching or being a student. So this is about working towards some goal and putting in hard effort, but it would likely be something that you enjoy. So you may be very focused on the details. It may require that. You could be, growing your talent or getting an education in some way. Maybe you're doing some training or studying. But again, the goal is to either improve self or your material security. So you may be looking for a new job or changing your career or working to be promoted. So you may be trying to get noticed for your talent and your skills so that you can move up, because you want to prepare for the future. You want to save your money, and you're looking at where you are investing and how much money are you bringing in for your skills or your talents. You may also be very cautious about saving, very prudent. And you may be dealing with some change this week, some challenges, some obstacles to overcome. But again, the Queen of Wands, she can be a motivational factor for you, perhaps. Maybe she's invigorating you to move forward. And so you're very determined to accomplish something. You're coming up with ways to save money, to do better, to move ahead. And you want to be actively involved in growing something. So again, perhaps you're going to go on an interview, or you're going to get a bonus or a promotion, or an award, something where you're recognized for your intellect or your skills or your talent. And for some of you, because this is all about your vitality and your passion, you may be working on your health. Maybe you're working out, or you're focused on the food that you eat, looking better, feeling better. For some of you, you may be exploring ways to expand yourself. You're passionate about something. Maybe you want to travel, or you want to expand your business, or expand your mind. Or perhaps, you're looking for that adventure and you're pushing boundaries. And maybe you're being encouraged to try something new. But for some of you, this is all about the finances. And it could be that something has come up. Some kind of emergency situation that you weren't planning on, and that you may not have been necessarily ready for, prepared to deal with, and now you're having to dip into your money, your funds, and perhaps, it's unsettling you financially. It could be that, you're dealing with somebody who's very difficult. Maybe somebody's overmanaging your work. They're standing over your shoulder, looking at what you do at every turn. You have to answer to them. And you may realize that the position that you have, or the company that you're working for, is having some difficulties, and maybe it threatens your security in some way. For others of you, you're having to pay close attention because you're dealing with a medical issue, or someone close to you has one, and that is proving to be more serious than you first suspected. But for others of you, you are dealing with a situation where somebody is very focused on those details to the negative. They're becoming hypercritical, either about your work or personality trait, or vice versa. There's been some slights or some criticism or some grievances, And somebody is holding on to that. They're not letting go. In other situations, you find yourself doing something repetitive. Now, maybe you're involved in a work where you have to do things that are repetitive, or maybe you feel like you're in a rut. Maybe there's some behaviors that you can't let go of. And for some of you, you're very comfortable in what you do. You don't want to change. This is what you know. I do this all the time. I do it over and over, and I don't want to step out of that comfort zone. So you may be indulging yourself in ways where it's actually becoming a rut for you, and you need to try something new.